My name is Amber. Thank you guys so much for clicking on my video and deciding to watch with me. Today we are back with more Amphibia. We are watching Season 1, Episode 12, Civil Wars in Hot Popular. I cannot with these episode titles. They are ridiculous, but I love them so much. I really couldn't tell you what's happening besides maybe they're gonna try to make Hot Pop more popular with the townspeople. I don't know. In a war? I don't know. But as always, I am interested to find out. Please remember, if you want to watch my full uncut reactions to Amphibia and other shows, you can check out my Patreon page linked down below and watch my full uncut reactions. But without further ado, let's get started!
Theater night. The one night a month we come together, watch our stories, and forget all our horrible, horrible troubles. Now, who wants popcorn? Get Polly to see.
Say what? Come on, Hop Pop. I got here first.
That's what older brothers do, Sprig. They look out for their little sisters. Now move that rum over to that stuff.
Oh. Wah, 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 wah.
Bummer, dude.
Ugh, it's just not fair. Just because she's a little younger, she always gets special treatment.
I'm an only child, so I don't relate. All my parents' attention was focused on me, and it was awesome.
Oh!
Lucky you.
All right, now everybody settle down.
Interesting. So no siblings.
News. The acting troupe had to cancel on account of, well, being eaten on the way here.
Oh! We made our story!
Hold up, everyone. I have something that might work. Look, choice. Which has always been one of my favorites because...
Just start the movie!
You got it. Dang it.
In the not-so-distant future, three grounded yet supernatural teens must navigate their feelings if they hope to survive.
Wait, how can they be both grounded and supernatural?
Shh. Oh, honey, I know that together we'll make it through this nightmare.
Constance, my cybernetic apps belong to you. And you alone.
Polly Likey.
Oh, no.
But I can't help but be drawn to you as well, Alistair.
May I sing you the traditional song of my people?
I like this, Alistair. He's ethereal yet approachable.
It is now time for me to make my love choice. I choose.
Oh, no!
To be continued.
Uh-oh.
What? That was the end?
Who did she pick? I'm so frustrated right now.
Hunter, he's a beefcake. Quick, she should pick Alistair. He's a thinker, a dreamer.
Oh, no. Shipping wars.
Everybody who chooses Hunter, get behind me.
Yeah.
He's so attractive.
He's so attractive.
Alistair can get behind me.
Alistair's my man.
Of course she sides with him.
Spring, just let Polly win this one before things get even worse.
Sorry, Hop Pop, but I've had it with this Polly Wong and her special treatment.
Oh.
We ain't backing down.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I'm sure my morning clear heads will prevail.
Oh, no.
I don't believe this. The town is split right down the middle.
This is ridiculous.
Hey, what is this
madness?
It's like an internet message board.
Yeah.
IRL.
Were things on this internet resolved in peaceful and civilized ways?
No.
Speak for yourself, dude.
Oh, gosh. I forgot my house was over in Alistair Town.
Ow! Damn that, you stinking hunch right.
Hey, Hop Pop. You ever play Capture the Flag?
Oh.
My kid Alistair last night. Wow, you're a good dad.
Oh, no.
Personally, my favorite thing about Alistair is how he's not afraid to cry. Ah! No! She's stealing the sacred flag! Somebody get him!
Or Hunter!
Tony!
Got it! Man, you did it!
Gotcha!
Oh, no!
For Hunter!
Oh man, I hope he was able to get the flag. Oh, that's captured!
Now what?
Now this. Ha ha! Tricked you all! Now that you're face to face, how about discussing this like civilized. Whoa!
So, older brother, you here to finally admit I'm right and surrender to the Hunter Tribe? Get first! Then perish!
Looks like your special treatment couldn't help you this time. Now just surrender and...
Enough talk! Let her have it!
Whoa, what?
Oh!
That's what older brothers do, Sprig. They look out for their little sister.
What have I done?
Seeing you in danger made me realize it doesn't matter what's fair. What matters is that I'm here to take care of you. We surrender.
Brother, no, no!
This is actually really cute.
Ooh, all right, folks, pack it in. We're done.
Yeah, this thing is pretty played out.
Wait, what? Glad I finally got a chance to use this bad boy.
You guys were at each other's throats just a second ago. Are you seriously over this already?
Oh, that's just the way we are, Anne. You should have seen last year's avocados versus almonds fiasco. We almost tore this place to the ground.
Hey, Sprig, over here. I saved you a spot.
And I brought you some sweets.
You're a good older brother, Sprig.
Ah!
Ain't that nice? Now scooch over, I need a seat.
Hello, everyone! For tonight, I've picked a conflict-free independent film called My Dinner with Anders. But before we start, a little context.
Just stop the movie!
You got it.
Huh. Interesting. That's fun, though. I like how they, like, made a movie theater, basically. It's cute.
Hey,
Hop-Hop.
Got the groceries.
Couldn't buy much since we barely got any money left.
Feeling any better, Hop-Hop?
No. Ever since we lost the vegetable stand, I just felt, well, lost. I was fine the first couple of days, but it's really starting to catch up with me.
Well, maybe this will cheer you up.
Pow! It's rubbing those hiring greeters. All you gotta do is smile and be friendly.
That's the worst.
For me to lose.
My lot's for the election.
You've been living under a rock.
Sorry, Anthony, but I knew that.
Election? Vote Mayor Thompson. Oh! I will always look out for the little guy. Some mayor. That guy keeps raising our taxes. And what do we got to show for it? Our snail ways are a mess. Our buildings are falling apart. Heck, we ain't even replaced the schoolhouse after last year's millipede incident.
Oh!
Hop a dog, time for mayor.
I second that.
I third it. Let's hear it for Hop a Day.
Sounds good to me.
The dog of Ella.
Nope, I'm running for mayor. Don't you see, kids? If I win this election, I'll prove once and for all that Hop-A-Diet Planner ain't no loser.
You don't need a powerful enemy today, Hop-A-Diet. Sports have run uncontested for decades. This is a disgrace.
The only disgrace is you as mayor.
Ooh, I like this, Hop-A-Diet.
I don't know. Toadstool is tried and true.
Ahem. Welcome to the official mayoral trials, where the candidates try to win your vote.
Okay.
This is be very interesting politics.
That's how we fed us when we were babies.
Ow!
dropped in the woods naked and forced to find your way home. So that's what we did!
Thanks for showing me the way, Jeremy.
Jeremy! Oh, so cute! I love it! I love that Jeremy came back. That's adorable.
Mr. Planter, an anonymous associate would like to speak with you.
You mean the mayor?
No comment.
Come on, man. You only know like one person.
I said no comment!
Okay.
So glad you could join me, Planter. I'll get it to you straight. I want you to lose tomorrow's trial.
Well, yeah, I figured.
No, you dimwit. Lose on purpose. In return, I'll give you a new vegetable stand. I'll put it in the center of the market, tax-free. You'll make tons of money.
That's, hard to say no to.
Well, then, don't.
Hey, Papa. So, what did the mayor want?
If I lose on purpose, Toadstool will give us the stand back.
What? No! You've got a real chance to win!
He'll also make us rich. We'd be set for life.
Oh, in that case, take the deal.
Polly!
Polly's right, guys. It's just too good to pass up.
You know the candidates. You've seen them fight monsters. But for the final challenge...
They fight each other!
Each other!
Poor Toadie. Poor Toadie.
Now you both know the rules. Fight starts as soon as the bell rings.
What? Ring the bell?
Okay, Clarence, you put on a good show, but that's enough.
This can't be good.
Like we talked about. Stay down, Planter.
Because this is about more than just me.
Aww, half a dying planter.
That's a knockout.
Well, ring the bell.
So Hop-Up's gonna be mayor now? I like it. That's fun.
Well, folks, that wraps up the trials. Now it's time to tally the votes. With 88 votes, 100% of Ward Point, Hop-A-Dia Planter!
What?
Aww.
And with 22,000 votes, the entire rest of the valley, Mayor Toadstool!
What?
Congratulations, sir!
Well, you certainly gave this toad a run for his money. Good thing you didn't win, though, huh? A frog beating a toad. That would have made headlines. Just be proud the whole town loved you.
I'm surprised the rest of the valley didn't. How was I supposed to know the rest of the valley got a vote? I'm a theater major, for cricket's sake.
I'm a theater major.
You didn't campaign outside Wartwood? Ooh, son, that's just sad. Really is. Almost takes the joy out of my victory.
The victory pinata is all set up in the lobby, sir.
I did say almost.
You okay?
Yeah, I never felt better.
Hello? Really? You know you lost, right? Are you in shock? Is he in shock?
I may have lost, but I stood my ground and fought for something important.
Aww.
That feels good.
Hop-A-Dia, may we have a word?
We all pitched in and built you a stand for giving us something better than produce.
You've made us all proud.
That's really sweet. Granddaughter and human.
Hit the market with all of you. And that makes me a winner. This is perfect.
Aww.
I wouldn't have put the root vegetables with the tuber, so.
Oh my god.
Not important. I'll fix it later.
That was a cute episode! That was adorable! Honestly, this show always amazes me. I love. Like, I got really teary eyed there in the end. I wasn't expecting them to, like, make him a stand. That's so cute, and it just shows all, like, how connected their town is. I didn't think the whole valley had a vote either. That's kind of disappointing. But I get it, story-wise, it probably doesn't make sense for him to be mayor right now, at least. Oh, but it was fun. I like that we're getting more about Hop Pop and, like, developing his character. Because he's kind of falls into that old, not willing to change sort of thing. But he is. Like, he's always coming back. He's always come with a punch. He's always trying to learn. And I enjoy that about his character. I think a lot of people are very stubborn and stuck in their ways, so I really appreciate Hal Pop's character. That he, like, is stubborn, but he's still willing to learn and adjust. So I like it. And Anne's character was very fun. She kind of took a little bit of a back burner, but that's okay. I kind of almost like that about this episode. So overall, I'm super happy and content. I am in love with Amphibia. It's very interesting. A lot of great morals in this show. The story is very heartwarming so far. We still have Sasha, like, out there, possibly doing bad things. And the other girl, Marcy? Marcy is just not there. I don't know where she is. She's just not present right now. So, I don't know. I'm very interested to keep watching and learning more about this crazy, kooky Amphibia world. So, thank you guys so much for watching me so much. Please remember to like, share, subscribe, all that fun jazz, and I'll see you all later. Bye!